Most people think of photography as something you can only do during the daytime, when exposures are only a fraction of a second. But some photographers prefer to work at night, when exposures may be as long as a few minutes or a few hours.
My name's Larrie Thompson, and I'm a night photographer from Canada. Lately, I've been shooting mostly ghost towns and abandoned places on the Canadian prairies. In fact, nightphotographer.com began as an excuse for a road trip. I've always been fascinated by the little places you see along the highway. The idea of taking a road trip just to explore and just, you know, with no particular place to be, of course, seem very appealing. Night photography has proved to be the perfect excuse to do that.
As a teenager, I would go on drives out into the desert. We'd go for a couple days and cover 2,000-3,000 miles. I always volunteer for the late night shift because I just like driving at night. I remember blowing through these dusty little towns and abandoned places, and I always wondered about them. I thought it was kind of interesting that they weren't even on the map anymore. When I picked up night photography, I realized I could combine the two. So I immediately started shooting at night in the early 90s.
The way I got started in night photography was first the idea of motion. I was watching them changing the windows at the I. Magnin department store in San Francisco, and saw these men coming in with all these, carrying all these clothes, and they were dressing the mannequins who were standing there nude. And so I was standing outside watching this and realized that if I photographed it, it would be sort of a hilarious circumstance of these nude mannequins standing there and these ghosts coming in putting clothes on them. But it was, of course, at night. And so the fact that it was night meant there were longer exposures, even though there were lights in the windows. I was asked to teach night photography, and that put the circumstance to me in a very, you know, unknown situation, that there was not too much history that you could get hold of to learn, and so it meant starting from the ground up, and also, how are you going to teach it? Are you going to teach them to photograph Christmas trees and their loved ones by a lamp, or are you going to really get serious about night photography? And so I just decided to teach it all, to start with neon signs and go to no light at all except starlight. But it took a long time to get that organized, you know, getting the films and getting developers and figuring out the time exposures.
Well, I've been doing photography, night photography, for over 15 years. I'm lucky in the fact that I've been able to incorporate it in my commercial work. I am a commercial photographer, and that's how I make my living. I've had a good 20, 25 magazine covers shot at night because I've tried to talk the clients into that. One of the things nice about that, it gives me access to be able to shoot at night. You have the hard hat, the vest, required equipment, and of course, if you have permission, it makes life a lot easier. You can wander around facilities, climb on things that you need to do, and most of the day shift has gone home, so you can do pretty much whatever you want.
I first got interested in night photography something like 30 years ago. It came out of an article I had read in some popular photography magazine. It was all about going into a darkened field at night and running around with flashlights and strobes and painting with light. I was trying to think of all the different ways to depict motion. One way would be to put the camera on a tripod with cars zooming by. Another interesting thing I wanted to do was have the camera moving. I decided the best way to do that would be to strap it onto a car and drive the car around. When I shoot in my car, I put the camera on a monopod. I pop open the sunroof. I stick the camera up through it like a periscope. Then I climb up onto the car to look through the viewfinder, just to make sure it's pointed okay, and that it's focused out at infinity. And I have the release button sitting right there by my side. So all I have to do is hit it, and the camera will do 20-second exposures.
Daytime photography has always seemed too literal to me, and although I do photograph during the daytime, it's usually more as snapshots or typical, you know, pictures that everybody would take. I've always liked the transformation that happens over the course of a 15-minute or an hour-long exposure. One thing about night photographs is they tend to be really charged, emotionally charged. They're moody and atmospheric. You have this sense of mystery or the unknown.
Why do I do night photography? I enjoy the atmosphere of the night. I enjoy exploring these places. I just key into the mood of these cool abandoned places at night, and I just love when I manage to capture that on film effectively.
Became a night photographer, I think, and why it stuck is the actual experience of photographing at night. I was by myself. Everybody thought I was a fool, so nobody would go with me, you know. And so there's a peculiar zen feeling that happens, an alertness to danger, an alertness and a knowledge of the atmosphere that you don't expect. The personal experience that you go through yourself when you're taking a photograph is an alertness from many vantage points. You know what you're doing. You have to seeing that those little numbers at night. And so, but mainly it is the philosophy that happens in your mind as a result of doing it and being very serious about it, and then seeing the images when you. You've done one of those and it works. It is really an exhilarating feeling.